This morning in the Rhode Show Kitchen, we welcome GoProvidence.com. They've brought along Exo Cafe. Chef Marty Lyons is here. Marty, what are you making today?
We're making some crispy chicken confit with some sautéed kale, cauliflower puree, and a citrus and carrot gastrique.
All right, so a couple different elements going on in our dish. Take us through the ingredients of what we'll need today.
First off, the main protein. Have some local Buffoni's Farm chicken from right in Smithfield. Mm-hmm. Just got dropped off this morning. It was alive when I woke up, and now it's here on the plate.
Very fresh.
A little bit of citrus, vinegar, white wine, onion. There's a whole varying array of aromatics for the cure for the chicken. Fennel seed, peppercorn, orange zest, red pepper flakes, some clove, juniper, thyme.
Beautiful.
Some nice local kale.
A little salt, a little pepper.
Yep.
Beautiful. And some carrot juice, too, that I was spotting earlier.
Yeah, it's a base for the sauce for the dish. That was actually carrots I juiced right before I came here. If you don't have a juicer, you can use some bottled carrot juice from the store.
Geez, between the chicken and the juice and the kale, all very, very fresh ingredients. And you said the chicken, too. Some people are intimidated about buying the whole thing, but you say go for it, cut it all up, it'll make many meals.
Yeah, I just wanted, that was the thing, I just wanted to, I don't know, demystify the whole thing and get mm-hmm. whole animals. You can get a few meals out of one dish, get a stock.
It's not that difficult.
Yeah, not at all.
All right, this dish, we're going to show you how to make it in just a little bit. Back to you.
It's going great here in the Rhode Show Kitchen this morning. It smells great in the Rhode Show Kitchen this morning. We are going to prepare the bird, right?
Yep.
Get some of this ready. Some people are a little afraid. They're not sure how to take care of this, what to do. You're the guy to show us.
Yeah, just want to, we're only using the legs for the confit in this dish today, but I just want to show people that you buy a nice bird, you can get a few meals out of one thing and some stock and make some soup out of it. So
right.
It's coming out of the joints in the bottom of both of these. There's a breastbone right in the middle. Cut on either side.
What size is this bird? Because it looks like there's a lot of meat on this bird.
These are about 3 pounders.
About 3 pounds.
Like the spring chicken. Like,
yep.
Wind up with...
Take that.
Two nice 7-8 ounce breasts.
And you're going to leave the skin?
Yeah. I mean,
okay.
I get these whole birds.
A lot of times the skin has to be a great flavor on it, too, when you're cooking it. Put that in there.
Yeah, so you got 2 breasts for meal.
Mm-hmm.
You flip it over, go to the back. You're going to pop both these joints out.
Okay.
So everything's going to the inside of the joint, and just let the knife do the work. And the two legs are what we're actually going to use today.
And that, yeah, I was going to say, that's what we're actually using, right?
Yep.
Cut that. Looks like it breaks apart pretty easy, too.
Yeah.
And a sharp knife is key for this.
Yeah, so you wind up with 2 legs you can use for apps. You want to do breast for the entree, and then get a carcass you can make stock.
And use that for something else later. All right, so we've got that. You've got other ingredients over here that we can use.
Oh, sink's over.
He's just going to wash his hands first.
Yeah.
And then some of the other ingredients here we're going to use?
Yeah, we'll mix up the cure.
Okay.
About 1/2 cup of salt. And then about 1/2 cup of sugar.
Okay.
And all these other aromatics are just going to get tossed in. There's some juniper, fennel, some orange rind.
Some orange. All real fall flavors, fall stuff.
Yeah, and you can switch all this stuff up. It's like whatever you have, like allspice, cinnamon, like you want a little heat, a little salt.
You can mix it up.
Yep.
All right, so we'll put a little more stuff in here, and we will get cooking this in just a little bit. Smells great in the Rhode Show Kitchen already. Back to you. GoProvidence.com has brought us Marty Lyons from Exo Cafe. We are making crispy chicken confit, and that is what we're doing right now.
That's right. Bring us up to speed here, Chef. What have we got going on? There's a lot happening on this stove.
You go from one side of this kitchen to the other.
In the last segment, I just pretty much went over how to break down the bird.
Yep.
I didn't have a chance to show you curing it, so I have everything.
I think that's a really helpful tip, too, because a lot of people might be intimidated by purchasing that whole bird, but it's very simple and easy. You saw him do it.
And to break it down.
And here it is now.
Yeah, the legs is what we're using in this part of it. It's a very classic French preparation, confit. It was actually used before refrigeration because the meat is salt cured.
Mm-hmm.
Then you cook it in its own rendered fat. And if you leave it submerged in fat, it'll keep for weeks and weeks and weeks.
Really?
There's no air getting to it. Like, still, in your fridge, it'll last... for months, honestly. It's a
But I'm sure people might even want to eat it tonight. So
just in case the board is watching, we'll take that out of there before that.
I was just giving a little history lesson. So you would leave it covered in this overnight for at least 24 hours, and then rinse it, drain off the excess liquid, and then you can cook it. I use duck fat at the restaurant and those chicken, or at home you could use olive oil.
Right.
Okay. Nice rich oil, and you can reuse it and reuse it and reuse it, and the oil will get
more flavor as it goes along.
There you go.
Beautiful.
I have start and end product of the cauliflower puree. It's just garlic, onions, cream, some white wine, cauliflower.
And what a difference, too. I mean, you're seeing whole pieces of cauliflower, and then this puree is, wow.
And that's actually not even passed through any strainer. Cauliflower breaks down nice and gentle.
Beautiful.
Right up front, there's a gastrique. It's just... it's a term most people don't know. It's a reduction of vinegar, sugar, till it caramelizes.
Okay.
I use some carrot juice and citrus just for a little extra flavor.
Right.
All right.
And down here.
And here we go.
Will said he was all over the place. He is all over the place.
We have some confit that is done. That cooked in the oven for about 3 hours.
Okay.
Almost
oh,
4 hours.
Right.
So like 250 degrees, like really
low
nice and low.
Low and slow.
Yep.
And that there.
It's completely cooked and done, but it'll have a really pale color just from the low cooking temp, so just don't remove them.
Okay, but that is finished. That is what it should look like.
It's totally cooked, but the crispy part, we'll hit it in a nice hot pan.
Let's do it.
And then put that on there.
The flavors are incredible. I mean, it smells so good in here, and you're doing skin side down.
Yep. Just to get it nice and crispy.
Yeah, you throw it in a nice hot pan. I have your oven jacked up to about 450 degrees.
Okay.
Make sure you have a nice oven safe pan.
And then put it in there.
Yep.
And how long will it have to sit?
If you have a nice hot pan, hot oven, like 5, 6, 7 minutes, that'll be done because it's fully cooked. You're just adding color and crisping up the
skin.
Right, okay. Great.
Okay. So, and then.
This cauliflower, about how much time does it take to go from one to the other?
The cauliflower would take about 15, 20 minutes.
Okay.
You'll be able to tell. You'll be able to hit it with a spoon or a
mush down. And it'll break down quick.
Yep. Throw it right in a blender, puree it up, and.
And there you have it.
Yeah.
You also have some greens over there that I know you were working with, too.
I'm glad you said that part.
There's a lot, Chip. That's why
there's
you brought us
stuff.
In
you
here.
There's a lot of ingredients all over the place.
Yeah, it's actually some nice kale's just coming into season. Some nice hearty green.
We've cooked with kale on our show before. It breaks down somewhat like spinach. Is that right? In terms of, you know, it looks like there's an abundance there, but once it starts to wilt a bit.
That's enough barely for two portions. It has a little more body than kale. And doing kale, it's like a nice, really hot pan.
Okay.
Do some garlic. A little bit of red pepper flakes to let it bloom out.
Mm-hmm. We like the kick.
Put that in there.
Throw those in there.
All right, well, that's going on. Tell us about the restaurant itself for anybody who may not know.
SO Cafe, we're right down on 125 North Main Street. Mm. Focus on local seasonal food. I've been there just a year. Mm-hmm. You guys had me on right after I started about a year ago. Place is going
well,
a little
now
more
you're
smooth.
Warmed up.
And now you're back
you're
again.
Used to us.
Yeah, I mean, we're switching up the menu right now to the fall. It's like some people thought it was a little late. I was just holding on to summer as long as I could.
Absolutely.
I'm still getting beautiful local tomatoes and stuff until a week ago.
I think a lot of people appreciated that.
Yeah, and now we're switching over to stuff like confit and braising and all the good stuff.
Some comfort food, some great local products being used, too. Make sure you check them out and check this recipe out, too, on our website, the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.